My game Brazilian Street Food Simulator went viral just 2 hours after the trailer was published in August last year. In just a week, the trailer had 1 million views on Twitter, and it had been showcased by big streamers and all Brazilian gaming news outlets. Even one of the biggest Brazilian newspapers published an interview with me about the game. Of course, I'm very happy with its early success. But the problem is that after that, I've been living hell and going insane while I'm trying to make this game. But before talking about that, let's rewind a bit. My name is Alfred, you can also call me Pardo, and let's get started. January 2022. My New Year's resolution was to make a small commercial game and publish it on Steam in the same year, 2022. Long story short, I invested 7 months in experimenting with ideas, concepts, and making different prototypes. Then, precisely on the last day of June, I came up with the concept and idea for the game Brazilian Street Food Simulator. I had the concept for Brazilian Street Food Simulator very well laid down. A simple simulator game where you play around with Brazilian street food machines in a Brazilian environment. There would be no management, no tycoon features. So no customers, no human models, no timing mechanics. I was heavily inspired by Fernbus and The Ramp, which are very, very chill simulator games. It would be most like a Machine Tamagotchi, a tiny scoped game that I would sell for just $2 on Steam. 49 days later, by 19th of August 2022, I finished the trailer for the game, published the Steam page, and published the announcement to it with the trailer. I also published about the game in a Brazilian gaming forum, Adrenaline. Igodoni from the forums sent the trailer link to Alan Zoka, a Brazilian streamer with 6 million followers, and Adrenaline, the gaming portal, from the same forum, published an article about the game. After those two events, boom, 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 everything exploded. I actually barely slept the next week, answering every single interaction that I saw on Twitter and the other networks, and I was doing interviews and much more. And one day I may talk about everything that happened during that week, but not in this video. Wishlist the game on Steam. So, the sudden fame made me rethink the game concept and the gameplay that I defined previously. That's why when I started losing my mind. Basically, every day from August 2022 to October 2022, I redesigned the concepts and the game design document for the game multiple times. I just couldn't come up with an idea that was satisfied with, because I wanted to please everyone that came from the student fame and from the thousands of wishlists that I got for my game. And to make things worse, there is another thing. But just let's stop for a second. If you don't know, games are made with game engines, which are softwares with tools and capabilities to make games, such as daily with rendering, physics, controls, and more. And there are three big names for making 3D games. Unity, the world's most used engine, Unreal Engine, which is Fortnite's engine and the engine with the realistic visuals out of the box, and Godot, a small, lightweight engine growing in popularity. I know Godot since 2018, I know Unity since 2010, and I learned Unreal Engine from January to April last year. Okay, now back to topic, now that you know what's on the game engine. I made the game trailer in Unreal Engine 4, so the engine from Fortnite. And due to my initial concept, I was sure I would make the game with Unreal Engine 4. But during the many design iterations after the fame, I also kept prototyping those new concepts using all the three engines at the same time. So now I was even deeper in hell. I couldn't decide which game concept to make, and I couldn't decide which game engine to use. One could say that this is the case of a magpie developer, that I am a magpie developer, that we are too easily distracted by shiny new toys and playthings. But the thing is, due to my condition as autistic, I get easily frustrated. And if I keep getting frustrated for too long, everything falls apart for me. So my way to cope with that is to just jump ship. But in this case, I don't give up. I just jump ship by trying new things or by using the things I know, because I reached a point where I don't have to follow tutorials to do stuff with all those game engines. So for me, it's too easy to jump around. Fast forward a bit, in December 2022, I have finally decided for a game concept that's a derivation of my original idea, a bit bigger in scope, but manageable. I was finally satisfied with a game concept. Then, fast forward 3 months, as of today, March 2023, due to being stuck in game engine choice paralysis, I have made the same mechanics, the same game concepts, and reached the same progress with 3 engines at the same time. But bear with me, this is not a good thing. There is no use advancing the game a bit in one engine and a bit on another. This is not leading to a finished game, a finished product. I have to stick to a single engine and finish the game in a single one. Shouldn't I just pick the engine I enjoy the most? But the thing is, I enjoy all of them. Shouldn't I just pick the one I'm most familiar with? I kind of equally know how to use Unity, Unreal, and Godot. And I call this the knowledge curse, the knowledge hell. You can't get out of this vicious loop of constantly think that the other option would be better. Because in my case, I know how things work in each one of them. So anytime I make significant progress in one engine, my brain teases me saying, yeah, but in that other engine, this would be much better than guaranteed. And I go like, yeah, you're right. Let's switch and migrate the previous 2 weeks of work to that other engine again. And then the game goes back 2 weeks in progress again. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is how 1 year and 3 months later, I have progressed development of my game 12 times, and at the same time, I haven't progressed anything. But not everything is lost. Today, at the recording of this video and this devlog, I finally found my solution. So be tuned for the next episode, where I review my strategy to choosing an engine and to finally hold accountable. But let's talk about that later. So bye. And of course, don't forget to wishlist the game on Steam. Bye bye.